Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube, and this morning we're going to talk some golf, we're going to talk some travel, and got Mike McGann from Legends Radio right across the desk from me.
Who?
Good to see you.
How are you, Dan? Nice to see you, my friend.
It's always a pleasure, and of course, we've got a whole bunch of incredible deals that I know will amaze you, and some news that will probably surprise you, both on golf as well as on travel.
All right.
And in just a little bit, I am going to review a couple of things. We will be reviewing the Crane Watch Golf Club in Palm City, formerly known as Evergreen.
Okay.
We also will be reviewing the ShotScope Pro L1 Laser Rangefinder, which I had an opportunity to try out while playing the Crane Watch Golf Club.
Okay.
And a new pair of golf-specific sunglasses, which don't obviously have to be used only on the golf course, from Tifosi Optics, known as Sentis. And, of course, I had a chance to try them out on the golf course as well. So it's kind of a package deal.
So they sent you a Sentis.
They did. Yeah, that's kind of weird.
I love that other pair. I mean, those are
Tifosi
great.
Tifosi makes amazing sunglasses at a very, very reasonable price.
Crazy affordable. I don't know how they do it, but they're good products, Dan.
Yep. So we'll talk a little bit more about that in just a couple of moments. And, of course, we always like to kick it off with a little bit of golf news. And a week ago, we had no idea that our most famous local golfer would be the leading story in the news of the world, not just the sports pages.
Yeah, not golf related at all. What a story. Huh?
Crazy. Of course, we're talking about Tiger Woods, yeah. Who got in a pretty bad car accident out in L.A. And he recently was transferred to Cedars-Sinai to continue his rehab, had major surgery, mostly on his right leg, several broken and shattered bones, swelling, and
compound fractures. I mean,
yes.
I mean, Tiger is very, very lucky to have come out of that alive.
Right. Nobody's mentioned his back. I know my wife has had some fusion surgery, and I mean, a fender bender would be a disaster for somebody who's had back surgery, so that remains to be seen. Nobody
right.
has spoken about how that's going to be, but of course, he was still in rehab for his back. So now he cannot do that any longer, so that's all going to have to probably start over again. It's going to be a long road back. He's lucky he's alive. We're all lucky that he's alive, and whether or not he plays golf again is still unknown, but everybody hopes that he does, and if anybody can do it, he's already come back from amazingly difficult
surgeries.
How
many times? I mean, Tiger, yep. is the definition of the comeback kid.
Absolutely.
And with that talent, we'll see how it goes.
And, you know, fortunately for him, if he can't play at a professional level, he still, you know, has a design business and all sorts of other things, obviously, that he's capable of doing. So he will lead a fruitful life, thank goodness.
No matter what,
because it could have been much worse.
It certainly could have been.
Also, last week, the tour, of course, was out in L.A. at Riviera, and Max Homa beat Tony Finau at the end for the win. It was his second win. He's kind of a hometown guy, grew up around that golf course in that area, was very emotional, so congratulations to Max Homa. This week, finishing up today, several events. We've got the World Golf Championship Workday Championship at Concession, which is supposed to be in Mexico, but due to COVID, it is at Concession, which is just outside of Bradenton, not too far from here.
Okay.
Also, ending later today, the Puerto Rico Open on the PGA Tour 2, being that the World Golf Championship is an invitational, only the top 72 players kind of get invited. Pardon me. So that leaves a lot of other players for that full field. So many players that don't get a chance to play regularly get an invitation to play in Puerto Rico, so sometimes it can change somebody's life if they finish high up and then, you know, get their ability to get playing on a regular basis as
right.
opposed to only every once in a while when there's two events. Also on the LPGA Tour, just up the road a piece at Lake Nona in the Orlando area, the LPGA women will be playing in the Gainbridge Championship. Of course, Annika Sorenstam is making her comeback officially, playing on the LPGA, at least in this event, because she happens to live in Lake Nona.
Okay.
And the Champions Tour will be ending their event out in Tucson, Arizona, the Omni Tucson National Golf Club, the Color Guard Classic, and Boca resident Bernhard Langer, the defending champion there.
All right.
Now, what would have been the biggest news story in the world of golf had Tiger not crashed his car?
Yes.
As far as non-tournament type stories is Michelle Wee came out that she was thoroughly disgusted by a story that Rudy Giuliani told. A story about playing in a tournament with Michelle and the fact that the way she bends over when she putts, she's very tall and she uses a very short putter, and that everybody, including him, was busy looking at her panties.
Okay, stay classy, Rudy.
Exactly. Now, Michelle was a little concerned because she said she shot a 65 that day, beating every single man in the field. And if anyone was going to be talking about her, she was disappointed it wasn't about that.
I mean, we can talk about both.
But, of course.
My apologies on that one.
So the LPGA came out in support of her. The USGA came out in support of her. And it's just ridiculous that in today's world that stuff like this is still going on. But again,
I mean, that's an incredible round that she played.
65.
It's 65.
Exactly.
Are you kidding me?
You know, me personally, I obviously have noticed, you know, her putting stance as well. Not the way he did.
No.
My concern is for her back.
Right.
I mean,
she really uses a short putter.
Right.
I've got a bad back. I understand.
Exactly. I'm trying to bend over as little as possible and will try to stay a little bit more upright in my swing as well as my putting stance, even if it's to the detriment of my game, because my back just can't handle it.
I mean, it obviously works for her, but hopefully there are no long-term repercussions from it.
Just ridiculous, you know, what America's mayor has turned into in later stages of his life.
Yeah.
He literally, I think, has lost his mind, and bad enough when he gets into the political discourse, but let him stay away from the golf
Bring
world.
The other level down.
Yeah,
yes.
We don't need that. So in any event, that's what I got. I think it's time for our first break. So what we'll do is we'll take a break, and then I am going to review the Crane Watch Club ShotScope's Pro L1 Laser Rangefinder and Tafosi's Centus Sunglasses. You won't want to miss it, so stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Slowly falling off the edge. I better put my sand iron away. My best swing thought of the day is to use the Texas wedge. When you put one in the hole, it's like a victory.
Are you tired of searching for the job you need with the flexibility you want? Whether you're looking for a temporary or permanent position, you need to call Labor Finders. We're already in your community putting people back to work every day. Select from hundreds of daily job listings with companies who are hiring all over the country. With nearly 200 offices nationwide, Labor Finders has temporary and temporary to hire employment opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, and general labor positions, such as electricians, landscapers, flaggers, hospitality, and more. Connect with a personal job agent today to navigate your next career step by calling your local Labor Finders office or by visiting laborfinders.com.
Four. Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And we are back. And as I had mentioned, I had the opportunity to play some golf this past weekend at the Crane Watch Golf Club, which is in beautiful Palm City, Florida, where I happen to reside. The interesting part of the story is I actually bought a house in that neighborhood after I had sold my prior house, and the deal on my house fell through. So, of course, the purchase of the new house was, you know, contingent, so I had to back out of it.
Right.
And ended up living in a different golf course community. Right after that deal fell through, the golf course pretty much went bankrupt.
Oh.
And was closed down. And obviously, that would not have been a good investment for me. But since then, different owners came in, and maybe a little over a year ago or so, started renovating the clubhouse, the golf course, changed the name from Evergreen Country Club to the Crane Watch Club.
Okay.
And, you know, they started making some changes. I got a chance to play it, and they were in the early stages, and it looked promising. But, you know, with the economy and the COVID and, you know, who knew? Obviously, golf has been doing well, lucky for them.
Right.
But a year or so later, I had a chance to go back again. And the golf course is really doing well.
That's good to hear.
The greens were in perfect condition. The fairways were in good condition. The rough, you know, still
a little bit rough,
but that's probably one of the last things that they're going to address because it's the least important thing.
That might be a feature as opposed to a bug, Dan.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, the hint is get the message, stay in the fairway.
Yeah, you exactly, know, that's, right? It's called the rough.
For a reason,
literally.
Exactly. Lots of water, beautiful waterfowls everywhere. We saw lots of wood storks and sandhill cranes everywhere. Just a really, really nice experience. It's semi-private, so the public can play. Pardon me. And, of course, you could also get a membership even if you don't live there.
Okay.
The price right now, I think 7 days a week, peak season in the morning is $65, and it gets significantly cheaper later in the day.
Wow.
So not bad. It's probably a lot less expensive than, you know, around here in the Palm Beach area.
Yeah, big time.
And only about a 30-minute drive or 35-minute drive to the north. So anybody in our listening area who has not had a chance to check out the Crane Watch Club, I advise that you do it. Cranewatchclub.com is their website. Tell them that you were sent there by the Golf and Travel Show, and you will enjoy it. And my guess is it will only keep getting better. Yeah, I have the rates in front of me now. After 2:30, it drops down to
$33. $33?
Uh-huh, after 2:30.
Wow,
and now
that's
it's starting to stay light out a little bit longer. So you might not get 18 in, but you might get close.
You're going to get a nice round.
And from 12 to 2:30, $55. So, and of course, the weather right now, I mean,
it's
just incredible.
So nice.
So while I was out there, I had an opportunity to check out the ShotScope Pro L1 Blue Laser Rangefinder. That's a mouthful.
Nice. Nicely done.
But, you know, little handheld laser. I had an older laser from many, many years ago from a different manufacturer. I didn't like it that much because my hand doesn't stay perfectly steady and it's sensitive. And you think you're shooting the flagstick and instead you're picking up a tree behind the green. And it wasn't stable enough. So I switched to a GPS watch,
sure,
which also is older, and I liked using it, but I thought it was a good idea to see what the newer technology now has in this ShotScope Pro L1.
Right.
I was amazed. It was so stable. It has this stabilization inside of it that if your hand shakes, it still locks onto
it's
the appropriate target.
Wow.
You feel it vibrate, so you know you're locked in. And what's really cool is they have two modes right now, one with and one without, including the slope. So if you're 150 yards out, but it's uphill, it might tell you that it's going to play like 160 yards, which is great for an amateur golfer.
Wow, it takes all that into account, huh? It
takes everything into account.
That's amazing.
Of course, if you do play in tournaments or, you know, semi-pro type stuff or any kind of tournaments, that might not be legal, so you could switch to the other mode that does not give you that benefit.
Sure.
But even the PGA of America, for their tournaments, I think we announced last week, they're allowing these in their championships, the PGA of America, even for the pros. So it speeds up play. You know, even if you have a caddy, the amount of time it takes for them to go through all their calculations to tell you your distance, if you just use this in 2 seconds,
you're done
you
in
know.
2 seconds. Yeah, it really does speed everything
so
along.
Really beautiful. It sells for $199.99. Obviously, you could get information about where to find it at shotscope.com. But actually, in my hand, I'm holding a unit that they sent to me to give away to one of our lucky listeners. So
okay.
We haven't quite figured out how we're going to do that. But in the next week or so, we might just figure that out. So
yeah, stay tuned.
Listen to us, and you might be the lucky winner of a brand new ShotScope Pro L1 laser rangefinder.
And keep an eye. I might mention it on my Facebook as well as we get going. So.
There you go.
Yeah.
Also, I had an opportunity to wear these brand new Tifosi Centis glasses. It was a color, I think they called it iron, which is... I don't know. It's kind of like a bronzy kind of a color for the frames, as well as a brown lens on this particular one. They do have three other colors. I believe they've got a black, both a matte as well as a gloss finish, and maybe one other color, and each one comes with different lenses. What I like about it is they're kind of a wraparound, so that you know, driving here on I-95, especially if you commute, you got the sun coming in the side of your car in one direction going, another direction coming back, and I'm always playing with my visor in the car to push it to the side block it. Usually then you end up breaking your visor eventually if you're doing that every single day for a few years. This solves that problem. The lens is clear. It's meant for golf. But what's really cool about it is not only do they look good and perform well, but they retail for $25.
Because those are nice looking. Like, I like the whole thing. And, you know, I've got another pair, and not the Centus, but a different one. And they work really well. It's a quality product.
It's a quality product. Most of their sunglasses are about $75 or less. They do have special sunglasses for bikers, you know, cyclists, water sports, boaters, golfers, all different kinds of sports. I also noticed in looking at their website that they did have perhaps some older models or ones that are being discontinued at 50% off.
Wow.
So, you know, some of those more expensive ones, if you don't like to spend $75, you might find them for half off. So that's pretty cool. But being that this is a brand new model hitting the market at $25 retail, just crazy. So go check out all of these sunglasses from our friends at Tifosi Optics. That's TifosiOptics.com. Pardon me. Yeah, you'll be very happy. I've worn many of their different sunglasses over the years, and I've never been disappointed either with their pricing, of course, which is ridiculous, but the quality too. So, TifosiOptics.com. And I think what we are going to do is take a quick break. I got a bunch of travel news and all sorts of deals that will amaze everybody. You won't want to miss it. Stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
When you see me tee up, you better step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. I hook it to the left, I shank it to the right. I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes, what do you get?
Do you have a project with an upcoming deadline, but don't have the manpower to finish on time? Or maybe your business just took on a new client and has a sudden demand for qualified professional workers. Whatever your business needs, Labor Finders has got you covered. Gain access to a steady stream of workers who want to work with an agency that always has placements. With over 40 years of experience in the staffing industry, your staffing problem is no problem to our team of experts. Labor Finders covers many services and costs so you can save time and money while getting employees you can count on today. We take pride in setting safety standards. Work with Labor Finders today, the best of staffing winner for 10 consecutive years. From event hosts, chefs, and housekeepers to general laborers, electricians, and landscapers, we have the workers you need. Consult with one of our nearly 200 offices today to see how we can help staff your next big project at laborfinders.com.
We are back, and one last tidbit of golf information. I've been reminding everybody for the past couple of weeks about the Honda Classic coming up in March 15th through 21st, right here in Palm Beach Gardens at PGA National. They do have some tickets still available for sale. TheHondaClassic.com is the place to go for that, and of course, being that there will be a reduced number of people who will be participating and in the gallery to help raise money for all the important charities in our community, go to HondaClassicCares.org. You can also add /birdies/donate. I'm sure there's a link there that will help you to get there, though. And you can pick from a whole bunch of different charities that you can make a small donation to. You can have a chance to win something as well. There's like a raffle. Wheels for Kids is my favorite charity. I've worked with them for many years. They make custom wheelchairs for kids, and they're really a good charity. So give them a shot if you care to, or pick any of these other worthy charities of your choice. They are all deserving. Again, HondaClassicCares.org is where you would go for that. Let's change hats and talk a little bit about travel.
Alrighty, I always love this.
So there was a poll that Trivago recently did.
Okay.
And maybe surprising, maybe not surprising, But 38% of all Americans that were polled by Trivago, which is a good site, by the way, to look for lodging. I like them. 38% of Americans said that they would give up sex for a year if they could resume traveling immediately.
People are desperate for travel, aren't they, Dan?
I have a funny feeling if they travel to some romantic place, they may regret their decision, you know?
Once they get there. Excellent. Yeah,
And who's going to follow them to find out?
Are there some caveats around this thing?
I know. I think people are going to cheat. I don't know. I don't trust anybody, but I just thought that was pretty interesting.
That's quite a thing.
Share that. Things are starting to come back in Las Vegas, though. A lot of the shows are starting to reopen with limited capacity, but with the hope that the capacity will increase. Carrot Top has already returned a couple of weeks ago, if you care to see him. The Las Vegas Knights hockey, they're going to be allowed to have 20% of their seats filled. I believe David Copperfield is coming back as well.
Wow.
Brad Garrett's Comedy Club. Thunder from Down Under. I know that's one of your favorites, Mike.
Oh, yes. Yes, indeed.
So Las Vegas is coming back. The Bahamas is starting to come back. Just heard that Bahamar, which is a complex that's relatively new with three high-end hotels, one of which is open, I believe, the Hyatt, and the other two, which are going to be opening in the next couple of days, March 4th, I believe. That would be the SLS Bahamar and the Rosewood Bahamar, which okay. I know my boss has stayed at the Rosewood. He loved it. He said it was beautiful. But they do have a program with on-site testing for COVID, and they have also a program that if you test positive, they'll send you home via private jet.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
So if you're looking for that private jet experience, you might want to go to the Bahamas and catch COVID. I don't know.
Oh, that's not a sentence we say too often.
Only kidding. Only kidding.
That was a good
but,
line.
But flying private might be better than flying on a Boeing plane.
Yeah, maybe.
Because, you know, their engine blew up on a United on a 777 Boeing plane recently, and they're investigating that. Luckily, it landed safely, but pretty harrowing experience for those looking out the window at the engine on fire.
Yes, big time.
Not a good look. Also, another Boeing flight had to make an emergency landing this past week as well because some of their emergency lights came on in the cockpit. They weren't quite sure what was going on, so they had to land, and everything was okay. Everybody was safe. Those 777s, I believe many of them have been recalled with Pratt & Whitney engines. Of course, Pratt & Whitney, another neighbor of ours here.
Yes.
So I'm sure they're a little bit nervous about this as well. But the airline industry... It's trying to carry on. In general, though, orders for aircrafts from Boeing, I think this past month they had like six of them for cargo planes, and they normally would have had like over 200 of them under normal circumstances.
Oh, wow, yeah.
So nobody is buying new Boeing airplanes right now. The industry is, though, trying to get some sort of way for people to document that they've been vaccinated and that they're safe or they have antibodies so that people can begin traveling more regularly with more ease. So that's all being worked on with the airlines and the governments. And, you know, we'll have to see how all that shakes out. But when you do feel safe to travel, have I got a deal for you?
Oh, boy. I love the deals. Tell me.
All right. So it's time for Dan's Deals on Travel. This particular one I found on one of my favorite sites, Travel Zoo. And it is a hotel in one of my favorite U.S. cities and one of the nicest hotels in that city. We are talking about Charleston. So for the folks who are listening, whether you're listening down here or you're some of my friends and family up in the Northeast, it is drivable to Charleston if you prefer not to fly. And this hotel is the Emmeline, or Emmeline, depending on how they pronounce it in Charleston. But it is an absolutely beautiful high-end hotel. Right now on sale through March as well as June 20th through August 31st. Weeknights, $169 a night, and weekends, $249 a night. That is a significant savings of about 45% off of their regular prices.
Wow, that is a great price.
Yeah, like I say, I mean, I'll show you a picture of their, it looks like a rooftop lounge with fire going.
Oh, that is beautiful. I mean, look at that.
Yeah, no, this is... high-end, you know, fancy digs.
I mean, you could hang out with friends there or sit out and read, which I would do both.
And of course, it's right in historic downtown Charleston there, where within a couple of blocks, you could walk to most amazing restaurants that you've ever eaten in your life. The foodie scene in Charleston might be the best in the entire country.
I'm a bit of a foodie, and that really is such an in-demand place.
I have been there, and you know, obviously, especially the seafood, the shrimp, et cetera, just crazy good.
It's high-level stuff.
Found these flights on Scott's Cheap Flights. You could just go to Google Flights and Google it and then book it with the airline. That's always the best approach, but these are just ridiculous. Fort Lauderdale, nonstop round trip to JFK in New York City for $61.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Round 61? Trip, Fort Lauderdale. Yep, $61. Or if you prefer to go to Newark from Miami, $59 round trip nonstop. And if it's easier to go to PBI, a little more expensive, $97 round trip. But for not having the hassle of going down to Miami, might be worth the extra $40 or so.
Yeah, maybe so, but wow.
Crazy. The Big Apple, you know. Hopefully soon theater will start opening as well, probably at reduced capacity. Might be something you want to think about.
It'll get there.
Chicago, the Windy City, right now, and these are pretty much through May, most of these deals I'm offering up here. Nonstop from Miami, 61 round trip to Chicago.
Okay.
Not too bad. From Fort Lauderdale, 61 as well. How about Vail, Colorado? I was out there not so long ago. The lifestyles of the rich and famous, beautiful. You can ski out there. This is September through November of 2021. So come November, they probably have snow out there.
Right.
Fort Lauderdale, 179. West Palm Beach, 179. Orlando, 175. It's not nonstop because there is no nonstop to Vail. But
right.
So, but usually at least double, if not triple, that price.
Yeah, that's an incredible deal.
Las Vegas, we were just talking about, 97 round trip nonstop from Fort Lauderdale through May.
Okay.
Costa Rica, Liberia, which is on the Pacific coast, the northern part, lots of the all-inclusives there. From West Palm Beach, 280 round trip, usually over 600. Ibiza in Spain, where the rich and famous of the world play for the summer.
They do.
557 or 556 from Fort Lauderdale or Miami. Or Mallorca, another beautiful place, island off the coast of Spain, as little as $543 from Miami or Fort Lauderdale. Crazy prices.
$543?
Yes. And again, usually at least $850 would be the normal price to go.
That's a huge savings.
Right. So if you've ever, you know, visioned yourself hanging out with, you know, the jet setters of the Mediterranean.
And I'm not available.
Yeah, exactly. So, this, you know, you would want to certainly go if you like the crazy lifestyle, the party atmosphere, Ibiza. And if you like it a little bit more toned down, Mallorca would be your choice. I know somebody recently who was in Mallorca, and it's just lovely there. So I highly recommend it. Go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow, like the page, and you'll find out what we're up to, if we're having any guests. And of course, we'll be back again next week, same time, same place, for another episode of The Golf and Travel Show.
On a tour of one night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band.
Thanks for listening to The Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Shoup. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of The Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.